Hello, how are you today? This is Bong Soo-jung, Korean labor attorney. Today, I'd like to talk about one labor case related to the unpaid severance pay for native English teachers. Also, what I can learn from this labor case. This is the actual case I represented. There were 24 English native teachers. They worked for one of the biggest English language institute in Korea. So this language institute have never paid their severance pay. The reason was they have a freelance contract. Also, their salary is twice more than the salary the other institute the paid. So those English teachers never request for severance pay to the employer, because in the employment the freelance contract it is stipulated severance pay is excluded because their wage is very high. Also, this already included in the wage. So all the English teachers for the last 20 years accepted that condition. So they didn't think of anything about some unpaid severance pay. Then a few English teachers visited this labor law firm and asked about some interpretation of freelance contract. So I realized that they never received the severance pay. So I told them, company has violated the labor law severely. Severance pay is mandatory as long as they are employed according to the Labor Standards Act. So I collected about 24 English teachers from C Language Institute. So I represented them to the labor office for unpaid severance pay and other unpaid legal allowances. So labor office could not make a decision for that. So we take this case to the civil court together with the civil attorney. Then we won the case in first case, the appeal case, and Supreme Court case. So how the judges decide was that the name of contract, it was a freelance contract. So the name, title of contract is not important. Important is actual work relation, how they worked as employee, like employer control their working hours, workplace, also how to teach it. So they controlled all. So the name of country is not important. They must focus on actual relation of employment there. Also, this freelance country include their salary could not this salary exclude the severance pay because they earned much higher than other institutions, so they are not entitled to the severance pay. So all English teachers previously never asked anything about severance pay. So this court ruled as long as they are employed, they are entitled to severance pay. Also, the article in the contract that exclude the severance pay, but it's not valid because the labor standard is mandatory, also minimum working condition. As long as they are employed, they are entitled to severance pay. So that is what court ruled. So finally, the language institute claimed, so they agreed to exclude the severance pay in the salary because they earning is higher than other institutes earning. So what they agree should be accepted as good faith principle. But labor, I mean the court judge explained that the labor standard is mandatory, also compulsory condition. So good faith principle cannot be accepted in Korean legal system. That is how the judges concluded. So they all 24 English teachers were entitled to the legal allowances. So this case we won. So through this case, we could learn that the labor case is decided by actual nation, not the name of the country, like France country, something like that. Also, even though the country excludes some legal allowances like severance pay, it's not valid because Labor Standard Act provide mandatory working conditions. So, okay, this is something we can learn from this case. Okay, this is all. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.